Welcome all to my channel Rendezvous with Dr. Pushpendu Rakshit. Hope this series of cyber alert and awareness has really played a good role in your purposes. So be a cyber alert citizen. That's what we look through the messages or the videos in our channel. So welcome you again on Rendezvous with Dr. Pushpendu Rakshit. Let us see what we have in today's video. Today we'll be discussing about social media hack and spamming. Yes, social media hack. As we all are using most of our time on social media, thus it is very important that we keep a proper check on that. There are many accounts that may be getting hacked, and if you watch throughout the series, we may be getting different topics on this. It may be phishing, it may be vishing, it may be related to logic bomb, it may be related to malware, it may be virus, it may be some sort of activity which is happening, or even it is related to the our financial crimes that are committed on the social media or related in general on the cyber world. So let us know more about this, friends. So in this, we generally see that social media hacking is done as a joke, like the attack by the people who hacked Burger King's Twitter account. So that is one of the recent case that you can see. So Burger King's Twitter account was hacked, and that is a big thing. So it is a common thing, because on social media, the controls and the checks are very limited, and we all are spending our good amount of time for the same. Even though for an average Joe, seeing the celebrity or brand post weird stuff can be amusing, it's a invasion of privacy. So many times we are not considering the social media as a private place. So we all are on the public domain most of the time, but somehow the other way, there is a privacy that needs to be maintained, and the cyber criminals or intruders do not bother about it. So they try to hack and they try to get all the details that we are having. That is called social media hacking. So all our privacy is getting breached. We are compromising with our confidentiality, with our privacy, with the data that we are sharing. We may be loving to have the photos at different places and getting posted on social media, different talks that we do, different activities that we do. But friends, we have to keep in mind that it is a way we are also allowing the other person to have a complete breach into our, you know, the system. So we are making it. So we need to be quite cautious whenever we are on social media, whatever the post we do, whatever the photos we are posting, whatever the dialogues we are posting, whatever the activities that we do, it is all seen by so many different intruders across the world. However, a hacker can also spread unwarranted content that can be distressed to the people who view this content. This can also cause your account, you know, to be reported or shut down. So you need to be cautious. If your account is hacked, people can use it for any purpose. Some malicious messages can be there, lewd messages can be there, some sort of morphing activities can be going on. So where your name and your identity is used for some or the other activity. So it is also a sort of identity theft. To know more about identity theft, you can see the series or the video in this series. Social media spamming comes when a person makes a fake account, which we can see most of the time. Most of the accounts are not the original account. Data provided to open an account are also fake. And it is like average people that we see, they are falling prey to this sort of fake account. So it can be an account which can be on the name of some superstars, but actually it is not. It is by a common man. Or most of the time we can see that either we are creating an account of some friend's number, name, friend's number or some other thing, and then we are trying to defame the person. So which is also not a correct activity. This is given with the fake account, the freedom of spam inboxes with bulk messaging, and it can be done by spreading malware. So there are on our name, there can be many messages which are sent to different people, but actually we are not doing it. So it has been sent from different people who are some or the other way have created accounts on our name, fake accounts. So celebrities do become victim most of the time of this sort of crime. On social media, we need to be very careful that we are not sharing our information under any circumstances what is not required. Spamming can also spread malicious link created with the intent to harm, mislead or damage the user or to the device. So we need to also be careful about the device as we are careful about the information theft for ourselves. Clicking on malicious link, that is a link bait that we call, which may be advertising a new iPhone or weight loss treatment, means that you are, you know, attracted to such advertisements or some offers or some sort of discounts, and then you will end up filling your personal information or any sort of academic course. So never to go with such unknown areas where you are not aware. Any sort of property that you are looking for, you want the, your data you are registering, but later on that data is getting utilized for some other activity. So first check the authenticity of the website and then only land up filling the data. But in hurry and worry, we many times land up filling the data, which is not a correct practice. Another dark side of the social media is the ability for malicious accounts to spam your output by constantly replying with negative messaging. So on behalf of you, somebody is creating a fake account and distributing negative messages, false messages. And sometimes someone can emotionally also make you fool. And on your name, some things can be done. So you need to be quite cautious. And it may be with the intention where somebody is trying to give you, you know, make you, put you in harm. For also, we are having a one form of trolling. On trolling, we see now that it has become a trend, and we will definitely have a separate video on this, where we could see that people are, whatever they feel like, they feel that it is the, you know, freedom of expression, so they can land up doing anything. But it is also, we need to keep a proper dilemma and dignity of the forum. We need to be having a proper understanding that we are on social media, so what sort of etiquettes on social media that we should be having. While you can easily report such behavior to the social media platform, report option is there. You can always inform to the admin, those who are managing such groups, remove the user and then block whenever it is possible. And also delete the content if it can be done. So that is how you can always protect your account from getting attacked, and you can save yourself. So this is what we learn on social media, that we need to keep always ourselves alert. So just being on social media, having an account on different platform is not what that is, you know, limited, just we are free with. So we need to be having a proper understanding of the system. Also, what are the platforms that we should be using, how we have to make the things going best. All these things has to be taken care of. So whenever, friends, you have your social media account, make a note that you are having the system integrated well, checkings are done well, and do not click on any unknown or unauthorized links that you are receiving. Even while clicking the advertisements, have proper check for the same before you are filling your personal data. Never share your account detail without having any information in terms of financial accounts, I am saying about for money transaction, and do not transact without having a proper understanding of the things. I hope this video is liked by you. So keep liking, sharing and subscribing our channel, and press the bell icon, and thanks a lot. Signing off. Good day.